One of NASA's missions is to advance US leadership in aeronautics. Part of that is performing high-risk flight research that may not necessarily be something that's so easy to perform in industry or academia.
eVTOL stands for Electric Vertical Takeoff and Landing. eVTOL vehicles can be both passenger-carrying vehicles such as air taxis, as well as uncrewed vehicles such as package delivery drones. The flight controls for these vehicles are very complex. You have many more controls than a pilot would have hands and feet to be able to control the vehicle, such that you have to have an automatic flight control system.
So no matter what, we need automation is critical in these aircraft, even just to be able to fly the aircraft in the sort of most basic means. Raven Swift, the Subscale, is going to be hugely useful for controls research and integration of hardware and software and the methods that we use to do that.
The Raven Swift Subscale vehicle is a vectored thrust tilt rotor configuration that has relevance to a lot of the eVTOL vehicles being developed in the industry. Subscale vehicles have a number of benefits. One of those is that it allows them to be developed and tested sooner than a full-scale vehicle. It also allows a more agile testing process because of the lower cost and time to replace.
The ability to do high-risk research really makes a huge difference here because we're wanting to go and investigate increasing levels of automation and autonomy. So we want to be able to go and push this aircraft to the limits and understand what happens when we have some sort of contingency happen. So for example, let's say a motor stops working. How does the aircraft recognize first that it's stopped working and how does it respond to that? And the only real way to go and test the safety margin that we have on these aircraft is to go and push it to those edges. NASA's willing to go and take that risk and publish the data such that everyone can benefit from it.
Safety is a huge part of this, and we need to make sure that before we introduce these vehicles into the national airspace, that they are safe for general public use.